Uzi. It ain't nothing to me. Young Tom Hardy with the movies. Act out smoothie. Mickey for the goofies. Pokemon with the hoes cause I'm choosy. Saying she a foodie. Thinking she uni. And she always stressing about uni. Think it's my duty to go and get faded with my goonies. Down shots like Lil Uzi. I done had 4 long nights this week. Try and stack my kills, my kills, my kills. Hit up my spot, gon' chill. Every wish give me my bills, my bills, my bills. I spit gold too much. Might as well make myself some grills, some grills, some grills. Hitting these goals too much. Pour some beer to the brim. Might spill, might spill, might spill.
What's good, everyone? Happy New Year's to all. Hopefully, all of your resolutions end up coming true. To start off, you know, January, we have our Mb1 versus Clyde All-Pro comparison. So a lot of you guys have been asking me about, like, my opinions of the Mb1 versus the Clyde All-Pro, so I thought I'd make a nifty video to hopefully clear some things up for you guys. So starting off with the traction, the Mb1s have this translucent traction pattern with Puma's anti-slip compound, while the Clyde All-Pros have a solid rubber, almost like a herringbone traction pattern. For the most part, I thought the MB1's traction was pretty solid, especially on a clean court. However, on dustier courts, the traction does get slick until you wipe it. That's just due to the nature of the translucent outsole. But after a few wipes, you are good to go. Whereas the All Pros actually had a very, very consistent traction pattern, no matter the court condition. On the same court, I did feel that the All Pros had a bit of a better and more consistent bite than the MB1s and with less wiping. And for that reason alone, I do think the All Pros win this traction categories by a fair bit. Not only that, I actually found the MB1's traction to be sometimes inconsistent. Different kind of courts are better for the MB1s than other courts, but the Clyde All Pros, they literally are one of my go-to traction shoes. Overall, I would say the MB1 has an 85 out of 100 for the traction department, while the Clyde All Pros get a 90 out of 100. Onto the cushioning department, the Puma MB1s utilize Puma's nitro cushioning technology to provide the superior responsiveness while being lightweight. And I really did enjoy the cushioning on the MB1s. They were pretty responsive while being low to the ground. The All Pros, on the other hand, had a pretty average setup with some Phylon, I guess, and a PBAX puck on the heel. The cushioning in the forefoot, I would say, is not the best at all. There's barely any cushioning in the forefoot, very little impact protection. But the PBAX in the heel is actually very comfortable. However, one of my main concerns about the PBAX puck in the All Pro was that the lack of support you had when heel striking and etc. because it was so soft and responsive. And if you kind of look at Boost, right, which is pretty much the same as PBAX, you can see that they often cage it in like hard plastic or a harder foam to provide rigidity. But in the Clyde All Pros, they didn't really do this, so it was kind of like unstable, but it wasn't a really big deal. The MB1s, on the other hand, had a really good cushioning setup, actually. The impact protection was good. Not as good if you were a big man, but they were still good nonetheless. And the entire shoe felt really responsive. Unlike the All Pros, where the heel is really the only comfortable part of it that I felt. In addition to all of this, the MB1s are more stable and they're supportive versus the All Pros. So for the cushioning categories, the MB1 has the better cushioning. So overall, the MB1s get a 80 out of 100, while the All Pros get a 75 out of 100. Finally, we got the support, containment, and fit. Man, I had really no problems with the MB1 when it came to support and fit, and the only really concerns that I had was that the narrow base combined with the lack of a lateral outrigger could be concerning for some people with weaker ankles, but the mid-top, I felt kind of counteracted that. I didn't really have any issues or any kind of fear that my ankles were not as protected as they should be. The All Pros, though, they were a very interesting shoe. The support was really good, literally nothing to really complain about. The upper felt good, and the outrigger provided good lateral stability. But the containment was very bad, in my opinion. If you guys didn't know, you can't really tie the laces too tight on the All Pros, because then they start snapping the kind of Kevlar reinforced strands that hold the laces together. And because of this, I always had to tie my shoes not as tight as I liked, and I felt that my heel was slipping out. And after all this, you know, my lace hole started ripping, and I just could not tie my shoes tight. So the containment on the shoes were really bad, and this is a really well-known issue within the Clyde All Pro community. On Reddit, there's countless people talking about, like, you know, just hole-punching it to get lace holes. But anyways, I digress. I felt that the MB1s were way more supportive and contained my foot better with less lockdown issues. The fit between both are very similar, but the main difference is that the MB1s are a mid, while the All Pros are a low top. And I personally love to play in low tops as it gives me more range of motion and I feel less restricted, but this is purely preference based and it's honestly not too big of a deal for me. So overall, I think the MB1's lockdown gets an 80 out of 100 and its support and containment gets a 95 out of 100, whereas the All Pros get a 70 out of 100 for the lockdown and a 90 out of 100 for the support. I would say that the MB1 provides better lockdown and support, but if you prefer the low-cut shoes and don't mind playing in something that is a bit more of a glass cannon per se, I would say pick the All Pros. Overall, I do think that these shoes are very, very similar, and it's really hard to say which one is subjectively better because they are similar, but I can tell you this for sure. I personally prefer to play in the All Pros because I like low tops and I really appreciate the consistency and tackiness of the traction pattern, and I don't always have to wipe it. But if you are someone that likes the mid top, then you know, honestly, the MB1s would be a good fit for you. But for me, I like the low tops and I like solid consistent traction and I don't mind sacrificing cushion. And if you play like that, then I would definitely say the All Pros are better. However, if you do value cushion and you value support and containment a bit more and you like mid-tops, then the MB1s are a perfect shoe for you. But in all honesty, these shoes are very, very similar. I would personally give the edge to the Clyde All Pros because they are low cuts and I like low cuts. But rest assured, you will be happy with both choices. Keep in mind, the Clyde All Pros are one of the best shoes released in 2021 and the Mellow MB1s follow really closely behind. You will for sure be happy with both your choices. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. It means a lot. And if you like my videos and reviews, please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting to help me out. Anyways, thanks again for watching. We out. Peace.